Just a quick word on this electric motor. It's from the 70s. The commutator, this copper area was really darkened where the brushes were running on it. So I did remove it because this is actually slowing down the motor. And I did use to clean here very gently. I did use a very fine sandpaper. Again, the very fine, it's critical. You need to look for something about 800, 1000 grit or even finer. If it's coarse, it's going to score this surface and then the brushes will not make proper, if you want surface to surface, full multi-point contact. So the current will simply not pass properly. You will not get the correct speed. So I did this only on the surface here. I did show that on another video. It was really darkened actually, because the oil put on the bushings, so these have bushings here. The oil put on the bushings will always leak on the commutator and get varnished, darkened, and that blocks the current passage partially. So for this surface, that's how you work it out. It's important to kind of just work it out very uniformly. Don't just rub it against one hour area for a while. Really rub it all around constant. And if you find it's scored, you have lines like this, then try to remove those lines and get a really flat, nice, shiny surface. I can tell you something. If you look here, this was the rubbing area on the right side. This area here was the area that was never touched by the brushes. So this area here looks exactly like day one when the motor was new, and I managed to turn the right area, the darkened one, exactly to look exactly like the new one. That's what you want to get as result, and also has to be smooth. And also when you rub the paper, go radial, just around, do not move sideways. Very important. For the brushes, do not use sandpaper by any means. Any means. Brushes are very soft, made of graphite, and we absolutely must not score the surface in any way. Use only isopropyl alcohol, just rub it gently at the tip here. Also, remember that the brushes are concave. You notice the circular surface that must, when you put them back in place, match the round surface of the motor. So be very careful not to place them by mistake like this. This is wrong. It's not going to work. Always touching and matching the surfaces. Now, a small word for the rod in the center. Again, I was saying, this motor has bushes, so it's just regular bushes. It's really just a metal sleeve. There's no bearings, no nothing in there. For these surfaces, do not, I repeat, do not use sandpaper here or to clean inside the bushing. Never, whatever the fine grit you have, always for that surface use steel. I'm not sure what the name is. Steel, wool, sponge, whatever. It's bigger piece, but I just cut a small piece. You want to get this and just maybe clean, rub against the stem, just around it, rub it like this. Again, circular movement, rotation, not like this translation. Really just rub it around the place where the bushings are sitting to clean that place, to remove old oil varnish. And if you have access, you can also insert a piece inside the bushings and just rotate it gently. This is more difficult. I suggest you don't try to remove the bushing from those retaining clips, because you may have trouble putting it back in place. So just rub that thing, and this is going to keep the surface from being scored and clean the old varnish. Again, if you use this sandpaper, no matter how fine it is on the surface, it's going to score it, and that's the worst thing you can do on a bushing to rod contact point. It has to be absolutely smooth. And also, you need to oil this. I think people like to use motor oil 0W30, for instance. zero grade is very, very thin. So some people put motor oil, other people put a very, very light grease. I'm not sure about it. Maybe try to use perhaps petroleum jelly, that's Vaseline for you. But usually, if you want, if you look at these covers, if you find a tiny hole like this, this is a lubrication for hole for oil. So maybe grab a small wire with a drop of oil, put it in there, and it's going to lubricate that yellow piece, which is actually something soft material that sits around the bushing, will absorb the oil and will have it leak, like keep it in contact with inside the bushing gradually. So it's not, it will last for a while. Again, you notice that piece that absorbs the oil, and the same tiny lubrication hole here. So you put a tiny droplet, use something like, do I have something like this? No, I don't have a wire, just a regular wire string to catch a small droplet of oil or small drop of oil. Put it in there, and by gravity is going to leak inside. If it's dry, you need to put more oil. If it has been regularly oiled, just a drop. Because if you put too much, I'm saying this in another video, it's going to leak on the commutator, and that's where the oil hardens on the surface and creates a blockage for the current to pass properly, and it will reduce the speed of the motor. Be aware that there are also sometimes sort of I would say washers in there. This unit had on one side, on each side had one blue and several red washers. I think it's one actually black, not blue. One black and perhaps three on one side, one black, three on one side. The black one, it's always the first that you drop in there, and then the red ones. So again, on this side, black first, red ones after it. And be careful, these are, I think, fiber, very, very fragile. Be careful how you slide it off from there. Maybe use something really small. Try not to grab them like this to pull them out. You may break them into pieces. One, it's not a problem, but don't break them all. And you need to remove them if you are just using this sort of steel mesh to clean the shaft here. You need to remove these washers. Otherwise, you are going to damage them. Let me just point to you one last interesting thing. Now, you see these bushings is really just a metal sleeve, but actually they are secured in place with sort of four springs, one on each side, and they are actually you're gonna see it really well here around the bushing. The bushing has a curved side, which means when you put the shaft inside there, inside the bushing, let's see, I don't have enough light. But you put a shaft like this, actually, the shaft can rotate by rotating the bushing into its springs. Let me just toss a bit, maybe a few things here. Okay, so normally, if you don't disturb the bushing orientation, it will stay aligned with the X. But if you push on the sides, look what happens. The bushing actually rotates. It's no longer aligned. And it can rotate in any direction. Now, what's important when you put the two halves in place, it's important to have the bushing aligned with the axis. And one way to do this is to put the two halves in place. So insert the other end into this bushing. I think I can try this. Maybe see if I can do it one hand. There is also the cable a bit on the way. Okay, let's just try the other way. Remember which half contains this end. So just remember which one goes where, right? Because the two halves, the one actually on this motor, the one that has the front bolts, goes here. I'm putting it in reverse now, so just for the sake of the video, let's try to put this with one hand. Okay, so assume, actually, I repeat, these halves are reversed right now with respect with the rotor. But just imagine it's like this. What you want to do, you see, if you look from one side, they may simply not look aligned to each other. So what you want to do, put them on a table like this and just press on them. Press on them like this. So it's going to be aligned on this plane, and then just flip them to one side and do the same thing. Try to simply press against them somehow and make sure the gap here, it's even from top to bottom. Again, the same thing here, gap even all around. Obviously, I'm filming with one hand. That's how you align the two halves, and then the motor can sit in there and the bushings are going to be correctly oriented with the axis of the motor, aligned with the axis of the motor. If you want. Okay, just a side tip for this. All right, so this is a very, very, very important. You see right now I'm kind of forcing on the bushing. That's not a good thing. You should not scratch the surfaces on the shaft or on the bushing. But I was saying this is an important matter for motor speed. You may have one of these motors that has scores, that is darkened here, that has varnish on it. It may slow down to half the speed or even more. So it's really an important thing to check. This, by the way, are from inside a sewing machine. Yes, a sewing machine also does have other mechanical components that may have issues, that may not spin properly. But if these are spinning nicely and smoothly all the way without getting stuck or grabbing, if the machine still is not fast enough, it's because of this component here, which is very easy to fix. Again, careful with these brushes. Normally you can also replace them. You may want to see if there is enough material in there, so look at them when the motor it's all put together. See how much of this material you see outside this kind of casing, these kind of tubes. See how much it stays outside, and then remove them and see how much it's inside. And if it's staying like this and still has a decent amount inside and still have a decent amount of spring pressure, then it should be good for a good while, for a relatively good while. And also, let me just point this before ending the video. My suggestion is to, before you try to put everything like this in place, make sure when you put these things in place, the commutator, it's degreased, doesn't have any trace of oil. And try to also use alcohol to degrease the tips of this, and put some alcohol to degrease the commutator as well, so you keep these two components really clean and free of any grease. Careful with your fingers when you work around. These have oil all over inside on all components. Careful when you, what you touch with your fingers. Wash your fingers perhaps. My advice, I'm saying, use isopropyl alcohol from a drugstore. Try to get the alcohol that says on the bottle 99%. You also have the friction one, that it's only 70%. That one contains 30% of water, so the water may take time to evaporate. But be very careful, do not use what it's exactly the name, those bottles with pumps that you pump and it looks like a jelly alcohol. Do not use that one, because that has other ingredients to make it kind of jelly. It's that thing that we use for COVID. Do not use that one. Use only pure isopropyl alcohol, because that one with kind of a jelly on it is going to smear the surface. It does not evaporate. Just do a test on your hands. Your hands will feel greasy even after it looks like it did evaporate. So that kind of whatever other additives are going to stay here, is going to cause a problem. So pure isopropyl alcohol, or if you cannot, get the rubbing 70% one and let it dry here after you finish cleaning.